Hi, my name is Marc Simard. I'm a neurosurgeon at the University of Maryland. I am professor of neurosurgery, pathology, and physiology. Stroke has many causes. There are ischemic strokes that we see and treat. When a patient has a very large stroke, one of the things that can happen is that the brain swells, and current management for those patients, unfortunately, is to remove a part of the skull to prevent the swollen brain from pushing on normal tissues and causing a patient to worsen neurologically or to die. Now there's hope for the future in that we're involved in developing treatments to prevent that swelling. Here we discovered the novel ion channel, which we named, it's a mouthful, but the NCCATP channel. I won't get into those details, but that channel is not normally present in blood vessels or cells inside the brain, but after an ischemic insult, which, you know, a stroke, for example, this channel becomes expressed, upregulated. And this channel, we believe, plays a very central role in the death of cells, of neurons, as well as in the formation of edema, which causes swelling of the brain. And by blocking the channel, we can reduce the amount of cell death and reduce the amount of swelling and greatly benefit patients. We've just completed a trial, a small phase two open label trial of the drug to block this channel. It's called RP1127. This is one of the most exciting developments, and that is that the drug has been sitting on our shelves, used for another indication successfully and safely for decades, nearly three decades. The drug is called glibenclamide, or another name for it used in this country is gliburide, and it's been used again three decades or so for treatment of adult onset diabetes. To see that that things that originate in a basic science laboratory can progress in terms of development all the way to the clinical stages of early phase clinical trials is a gift that few people are fortunate enough to receive.